Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Matthew, I am an automation advisor. In this tutorial, you're going to learn how to use the Windows built-in ping command to check server uptime using Febody Automation Workshop. Click on the New Task button. Creating a new task is easy. Just follow the simple steps from the wizard. We will need a task scheduler trigger to call the ping command every 30 seconds. Automation Workshop also has triggers to monitor remote servers using FTP and cloud protocols, but today we will use a task scheduler. Change the schedule type from daily to seconds. And set the recurring interval to 30 seconds, to start our task every half minute. Click the OK button when you are done. Next, let's add some actions. Click Add. In this case, we will need an execute script action from the run category. There are many ways to start a ping command, but the execute script action fits the best. Type ping and the name of your server. Then change the script type to batch file. Click OK to add this action to our task. To continue the task creation, let's make a quick look at the ping command. Open the Windows command prompt. First, let's try a server that is online. To confirm that our server is reachable, I would like to use the text packet sent and received and 0% loss. But let's try one server that is currently down. As you see, an unreachable server also reports 4 packets sent and received with a 0% packet loss. A quick Google search reveals that the most reliable way to check if a server is online is to use the time to live or TTL parameter. So we will use that. Let's return to the Automation Workshop app. Now, we need a condition to check if the TTL parameter is there. Let me close the unnecessary action categories. Click on Logic. Then Compare. And choose the if action. Use the variable wizard button to access the output of the ping command. Choose execute script action and select all output lines option. Click OK. The if action offers a quality check by default, but the ping command output contains a much more. So I will use does not contain condition. With the text TTL equals. So the condition reads, if output of the ping command does not contain the text TTL, then do something. In our case, the something will be email sending. So let's add another action called send email. Click OK. Then let's add the send email action. Let's close the logic category. And click on the send email action. Fill all the necessary fields. I want to include the output of the ping command in our email body. Use the variable wizard button again. Go to the actions category and choose our execute script action to get output of the ping command. Select all lines, as we want the whole output. Click OK to close the wizard. Click OK to add this action to our task. To recap briefly, our task will be launched every 30 seconds. It will execute the ping command. Then if output of the ping command does not contain TTL and an equal sign, it will send an email. Next, finalize the task creation. And as the last step, give the task a meaningful name. Now, sit back and relax, while Automation Workshop is doing all the work for you. Your server is being checked every 30 seconds, and if it is unreachable, the email will be sent. This is the first time our task was executed, and the condition was false. It means that output of the ping command contained TTL. Now, I'm going to unplug the network cable from the server. Done. The task is launched second time. And now, as we see, the email was sent. So our automated job works. You can further improve the task by adding an alarm sound when your server goes offline. Click Add Action button. Open the multimedia category. And click on Play System Sound. I will keep the default Windows alarm sound, but you can choose from numerous built-in sounds. Now, when the server is unreachable, an email will be sent. And an alarm will go off. Or you can add another execute script action to start a trace route command to the same server. And then by adding output of the trace route command to the email, you will get troubleshooting details in the email body that will help you to identify the problem cause. This is how it looks in the final email. Notice that I have added a little formatting as the Automation Workshop app allows us to send rich formatted emails. If you have not yet downloaded Automation Workshop, please do so via one of the links below in the description. No registration required, and it takes only a minute. I hope you find this useful, and thanks for watching. Till the next time.